to 2K Sports and another exciting edition of NBA Ball. Joined by Chris Webber and Grant Hill, our reporter Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. And we got a quick moment to take a look at the long-term rebounding numbers over several seasons for Tristan Thompson.
It's not a great trend for him. Not rebounding nearly as effectively anymore. Maybe it's his effort, or who knows, but that's something that needs to change.
So let's take a look at the Chicago Bulls starting lineup. Green out there with DeMar DeRozan. Then there's Nikola Vucevic. Then there's Zach LaVine. And it's Kusumu in at point guard. And for New Orleans, Jonas Valanciunas out there with Hayes. Then it's Brandon Ingram. Then there's C.J. McCollum. And it's Jones in at the three spot. And Grant, no shortage of athleticism on display tonight. Something you'd know a little bit about.
Well, you know, B.A., in my younger days, I might have caught a few guys, but maybe we'll see a few highlights tonight, too.
Here we go.
And it's going to be the Bulls off the tip. Pass to LaVine. Now Vucevic. Outside, Green. Over Valanciunas. And it's Green missing. Here's New Orleans now. Coming into this, having notched a win against San Antonio in their last game.
And most of the arena was totally against them. But they looked inward, trusted each other, and made good plays.
The crowd didn't seem to faze them at all. They knew what their game plan was and followed it accordingly.
Now here's DeRozan. He's a tough guy to check, averaging almost 28 points a game. Pass to Dosunmu. Vucevic with it. And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
High percentage look right off the bat.
Here's Jones. He's coming off a 13-point game against San Antonio.
Yeah, and his energy level in that game was amazing. He did all that work offensively and controlled the boards, too.
Now here's McCollum. Valanciunas sets a screen. Six to shoot. Vucevic with some nice D.
Look, they say there are no easy finishes in the NBA, but that should be easy.
Pass to DeRozan. Here's Vucevic. McCollum defends. And it's Vucevic. That time on the assist by DeRozan.
Just an intelligent play by DeRozan. Takes full advantage of the open gap in the defense.
Now Ingram, averaging almost 23 points a contest. A fantastic offensive player. Here's Valanciunas, and he makes it.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Yeah, very little resistance. I mean, you had to bring much faster help than that.
Here's Dosunmu. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Here's Vucevic. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Vucevic has got 6 points.
When you're trying to stop a guy like this, you have to match his intensity level.
There's McCollum with the three. Nails it from beyond the arc.
Well, he's a volume three-point shooter. McCollum looks to take this shot often for this very reason.
Pass to Dosunmu. Vucevic against Valanciunas. Nice move. Pelicans cleared away. Victory eluded them last time in Chicago when they faced the Bulls.
It really just wasn't a fun game for them. Their offense looked stagnant, and they couldn't get anything going.
And sometimes you have games like that, but you just got to shrug it off and move on to the next one.
The Bulls have gone 3 of 5 shooting so far. And here's LaVine. Nice start for him, sinking his first shot.
Oh, LaVine is such an explosive player. He's able to fight through the contact and get it to go.
The Pelicans trail. Ingram, the pass to McCollum. The floater. And it's cleared by Vucevic. The Bulls have gone 4 of 6 in the first quarter. And out of bounds, the Pelicans will take it.
Zach LaVine, the UCLA product, I mean, he has continued to improve over time. He's now a bona fide star in this league.
And the Pelicans shooting about 43% since tip-off. McCollum on the wing. 20 points for him last game against the Spurs in San Antonio.
Not to mention his defense. I mean, he was a terror. He came away with 3 steals and caused a whole lot of headaches.
Chris, you think back to the injuries LaVine has had to overcome. It's amazing where he is now.
He showed mental fortitude. He's still an elite athlete, but the sky's the limit for him.
Now here's McCollum. Unable to get that one.
Not the most productive quarter he'll ever have, but his shot selection's been a little bit dubious.
LaVine finds Green. Outside LaVine. Now Green. Clock at 6. Takes it inside. Vucevic. It's good on the putback.
Their defense just falls apart once the ball goes inside.
And it's Pelicans ball. Trailing by 5. McCollum with it. Green picks him up. McCollum's shot is off.
This has not been his best quarter.
Oh, just off his game. Forcing a few shots. Not letting the game come to him naturally.
Here's Dosunmu. Blocked. And here's McCollum. Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
Pass to Dosunmu. It's stolen by Ingram. On the wing, Jones. The 3. And it's Chicago with a board. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with Phoenix.
I really think that L has to fall on their defense, or a lack thereof. Just not enough focus at that end of the floor.
That's just the communication and the energy. It just seemed non-existent on defense, and that can't happen. Not at this level.
And it's a completely new group for the Pelicans. And over the last 10 games, here's a look at the teams that have been putting up the most points. 5th best, the Pelicans.
This team has been on an absolute tear offensively. It seems like they're able to find a shot every trip down.
New Orleans has gone 1-for-2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. Pass to Murphy. Now here's Hernan Gomez. Defended by Thompson. Here's Temple. 6 on the shot clock. Looking to end the run. No good there. Nice D from Thompson.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Caruso with the bucket.
The big story thus far, how well they've shot the rock.
Well, the Pelicans shooting just 25% from the field in the first quarter. Graham with it. 9 points in his last outing. On the wing, Snell. Defended by Brown. And he banks in the layup.
Primarily out on the wing. Every now and then, Snell can score it inside, have some solid length.
Pass to Thompson. Now here's White. Rebounded by Temple. Here's Snell, defended by Brown. Right side, Graham. White with the steal. And we've got 1:18 left in the first quarter of the game. Outside, Brown. It's Thompson, high post. Will not go, misses off the front iron. Graham up top, defended by Thompson. Here's Hernan Gomez, and stolen by Caruso. And up the court come the Bulls on the break. Here's White, rebounded by Temple. Thompson, no good. On offense, here are the Pelicans. 7-point differential. Over to the left wing. There's 31 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Pass to Hernan Gomez. Shoots over White. Hernan Gomez gets the bucket.
They allowed him to establish deep position. He just can't do that.
No, just too big of a threat down there. I mean, he has a number of go-to moves at his disposal.
Now here's White, guarded closely. He got a piece of it. Now here's Graham, still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Here's Hernan Gomez. And no good, trying to get that one to fall. Nikola Vucevic, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for Chicago. Dominating on the glass. What a quarter. Back to the game after this break. For those of you just tuning in, second quarter action is where we are. And let's take a moment here to get your take, guys, on the scoring so far for Chicago.
Well, they've carried out a great game plan in the paint so far, working it down low a lot and getting high percentage looks.
And I like the penetration. They're taking the initiative, attacking the lane, and forcing the defense to collapse.
The Pelicans trail. We've got Jonas Valanciunas. C.J. McCollum is out there with Brandon Ingram. Then there's Tony Snell, and it's Jones in at the three. That's the Pelicans' five. Now here's Valanciunas, coming off a 16-point game against the Spurs in San Antonio.
But it was his rebound that stood out even more to me. I mean, they could not keep him off the glass. The setup's good. That's the shot they're looking for, but you can't get them all to go.
And it's DeRozan missing. The Pelicans shooting a low 31%. Their offense is lacking.
It's been fun watching Brandon Ingram's scoring stats climb. He's a guy who can really fill it up, whether he's inside or outside of the arc.
A moment to hear from Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Brian. Well, Zach LaVine, with his first All-Star selection in 2021, and then the Bulls added a second All-Star, Nikola Vucevic, at the trade deadline. LaVine said, "We got another big-time player here. Guys, with this combination, they have a chance to be special."
Well, they're putting some pieces together, Allie. Thanks for that. And it's the Pelicans with the ball. They trail by seven. You know, Grant, what's really impressive about Ingram scoring is what he can do on those nights when he just goes off.
Yeah, we've seen some explosive stuff from him on the offensive end from time to time. Now, when he's dialed in, he can absolutely torch you. You just wish he could perform at that level every night.
The Bulls shooting about 47%, a nice number. LaVine passes to DeRozan. Here's Dosunmu. Up and over McCollum. Knocks it down from 7 feet. And the Bulls lead by seven.
Ooh, an aggressive move. Takes it strong, and there's no help defensively.
Ingram finds McCollum. From 10 feet away. That's good on the jumper. McCollum's got 5 points.
And it's encouraging whenever McCollum scores inside, proving that he's more than just a jump shooter.
Now here's DeRozan. Defense is right there. That one is off. The Pelicans have gone 2 of 4 here in the second quarter. McCollum outside. Here's Valanciunas. His numbers are solid, putting up around 18 points a game. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Ingram. And a slam dunk by Ingram.
Shades of KD and Dr. J. Ingram floating to the rim.
Here in quarter two, we played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Pass to Levine. Here he goes. Three-pointer, Vucevic. It goes again. His 6th basket in 7 tries.
I mean, this could end up being a big night for him. I mean, if this quarter is any indication.
Outside Ingram. Vucevic against Valanciunas. Valanciunas with a screen on Levine. Shot clock at 5. Ingram. And another one falls for New Orleans.
They didn't do themselves any favors with their shooting in the first quarter, but they're starting to pick it up now.
Out of bounds, it'll go to the Pelicans. And with the playoffs around the bend, here are the Western standings. Taking a look at New Orleans, they'd be watching from home if the playoffs started today. They're hoping to make a final push.
You know, for New Orleans, they've had some terrific moments this season. But where's the big leap upward that we've been waiting for?
Yeah, and I'm sure they're disappointed in that. I mean, they were hoping to take that next step.
Now here's Valanciunas. Pass to McCollum. Shoots over to Sumu. That one a little long. Chicago leading. DeRozan passes to Levine. Back to DeRozan. On the wing, Levine. Over Ingram. The Pelicans pull it in. Valanciunas has got his 5th rebound in this one. And Grant, for the super teams that are managing their stars' minutes right now, it seems like home court advantage is less of a priority than being fresh for the postseason.
You know what, BA? It really does seem that way. It's like you'd rather play with a stacked hand on someone else's table than play with a weaker hand at home. Championship teams know how to win on the road. The most important thing is being healthy and being together as a group going into the postseason.
All right, time for an injury report.
Thanks. I caught up with the head athletic trainer for Bulls. And this one, not something you hear often. A pinched nerve in his elbow. But from the sound of it, it's much more than just a funny bone. For a team right in the playoff mix, one can only wonder just what kind of impact this will have. Guys?
Well, and Allie, it appears that he needs some work done before he comes back to this one.
And we all know that if it's something he can play through, he'll be back, no doubt.
He uses his physical tools to the fullest when attacking the defense. That's a heads-up play by Valanciunas.
Timeout called here. Chicago decides to talk it over.
Yeah, they're hoping to turn things around with this timeout.
Yeah, they have to regroup and revisit their strategy at the defensive end.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. The 2K leaderboard featuring the best shooting team since the break. New Orleans, 4th.
This is a hot offense. Recently, they've had no issues getting the ball in the hoop.
Pass to Caruso. Driving to the basket and stolen by Graham. Six to shoot. Can't get the go-ahead bucket. The Bulls have gone 3 for 7 here in the second quarter.
Yeah, and looking at Devontae Graham, he came into the league late. He's shown he has no hesitation putting the shots.
Now Brown. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Shot to end the cold streak. Here's Thompson, and the slam dunk by Thompson.
Look, Thompson's getting after it. A highly skilled offensive rebounder crashes with power.
The Pelicans have gotten 6 of 10 shots to drop in the second. Nice work. Pass to Graham. 1:49 left in the first half of this game. Here's Temple. He's guarded by White. Hayes with a screen. Here's Temple. Doesn't go for him. Now Chicago takes it the other way. And you look at the shots Graham takes. 2/3 of them are from outside, Chris.
I mean, that's what he knows he brings to the table. He's a volume scorer from deep. You just hope he maintains a decent efficiency in shot selection.
The Pelicans trail. Outside Graham. Pass to Hayes. A 1:06 left in the second quarter. Here's Murphy, defended by Brown. Graham for three. Rebound by the Bulls. Here's Caruso. Thompson outside. Pass to White. No luck on that one. And it's New Orleans taking it the other way. 29 seconds left to play in the first half of basketball. Now Hernan Gomez. He's guarded by White. Fade away. Hernan Gomez, no good. And the Bulls shooting only 36% during the second. Thompson outside. Pass to White. Nails the wide-open jumper.
Well, he doesn't shoot a ton of mid-range jumpers, but White is versatile. I mean, he's got skills.
And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going here. Bulls out in front, up by 4. And don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number 3.
Hello and welcome. Before we take a look at the action from the first half, a brief overview of some upcoming games.
And for that matchup with the Raptors, this one is hard to predict because these teams are so close. The trick will be forcing the other team to play your style. Pace and execution will determine the winner.
And let's shift focus now to the featured matchup with the Chicago Bulls, who find themselves in a close one.
Great work on the glass so far. They're hustling and showing more desire than boxing out. That's what they have to do. That's the recipe for success.
Thanks for tuning in. Now it's time to head back over to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, this second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams trying to gain an edge. Nikola Vucevic has been sensational.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
And as they can't slow him down, you know what you do? You keep feeding him and feeding him and feeding him. This is the right game plan.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. And New Orleans shooting only 39% so far in the game. And so in the game for the Bulls, Green out there with Nikola Vucevic. Then it's DeMar DeRozan. Then there's Zach LaVine. And it's Dosunmu. In at the one. Chicago leading. And there's the rejection. Outside Jones. Pass to Ingram. Back to Jones. And it's blocked by Vucevic. Here's LaVine for three. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
Yeah. Off the pass, LaVine is more or less automatic. He just puts the shot right up.
McCollum on the left side. And McCollum slams it in.
A dynamic finish, then decides to hang out a little for good measure.
Yep, that's the exclamation point right there. And if you're just joining us, we played just over a minute here in the third. LaVine with it, guarded by Valanciunas. Shot by LaVine, no good. The Pelicans have gone just 1 of 3 in the second half. On the wing, Jones, defended by DeRozan. Here's McCollum. And it's cleared by Vucevic. Vucevic has got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one.
You gotta love how they've been crashing the boards, fighting hard for every miss.
Now here's LaVine. 7 points in the game. DeRozan outside. And out of bounds, the Pelicans will take it. And how about we check the numbers for Zach LaVine?
And he's had a rough past 5 games. He's had trouble finding his offensive rhythm and just hasn't been as effective as he'd like to be on that end. But this is something all players go through, and I'm sure he'll fight his way back.
Now here's McCollum. He's got 7. Rebound by the Bulls. Vucevic has got rebound number 11. Here's Dosunmu. Pass to Green. DeRozan with the ball. Guarded by Valanciunas. And the basket by DeRozan.
This guy just knows how to finish. DeRozan keeps his focus on the basket and delivers.
McCollum outside. Valanciunas against Vucevic. And again, no good by New Orleans. For Chicago, they've gotten 2 of 4 shots to go since the break. DeRozan double-teamed. 4-3. And it's Vucevic. That time on the assist by DeRozan. And now a 10-point Chicago lead. Well, New Orleans shooting only 35% so far. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
Hayes with a screen. Pass to Jones. Over to the wing. Shot clock at 6. Outside Ingram. Tipped away. And they forced the shot clock violation. Great D. And checking out the 2K leaderboard. Since the All-Star break, look at the numbers put up by this group of small forwards. In the third spot, DeMar DeRozan.
And it's clear that these guys work hard on maintaining their free throw shooting. It's why they're among the best in the league in that category.
And as good as they are from the line, it forces an opposing defense to play with caution against them. And that's never a good thing.
Chicago has gone 2 for 2 from deep here in the third. Pass to Dosunmu. Outside LaVine. Vucevic, a screen on McCollum. Here's LaVine. Drops in the layup for 2. LaVine's got 9.
His teammates keep getting him the ball in his favorite spots. He's done a lot for his shooters.
The Pelicans have gone only 1 for 6 here in the second half. LaVine against Ingram. Shoots over Vucevic. Off the left rim and out.
You have to credit their effort. I mean, they've done an amazing job on the glass.
Pass to Dosunmu. Drives to the hoop. Up and over McCollum. Dosunmu can't hit. They still have time to make this a game.
But they really need to focus in because they let this game get away from them a little bit.
And here's Ingram outside. And it's cleared by Vucevic. Vucevic has got rebound number 13 tonight with that one. Outside, Green. Outside, LaVine. DeRozan against Ingram. Puts one up from 19. And it's DeRozan missing.
A really tough night for him offensively. I mean, I wonder what the score would be if he wasn't so cold from the field.
Here's Ingram. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there. Chicago's gone 3 of 3 from outside here in this one. Green with a screen on McCollum. Here's Dosunmu, covered by Ingram. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. All right, Grant, if you could be GM for one rebuilding team right now, which would it be?
Oh, wow. That's tough. I mean, you got the Grizzlies with Morant, you got the Pels with Zion, you got the Mavs with Doncic. You know, I'll probably stick with the Pelicans and Zion Williamson. I think he has a lot to offer and has the ability to dominate in this league.
And the first one at the line is good. So Chicago going with an almost entire new group here. Thompson, he's checked in for Vucevic. Jones comes in for Green. Brown, he's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's White in for Zach LaVine. It's both from the stripe. They're having very little success right now.
And they really could take a different approach, right? Find something that works.
The Bulls making a switch here. Caruso's checked in. Here's Snell. Pass to Snell. Hernan Gomez sets a screen. 5 to shoot. Oh, a terrific swat!
And right now, they're +8 in the rebounding category. That's helping them run away with this.
The Bulls with another miss. Pelicans shooting at 32% from the floor. Not good. Here's Murphy, defended by Brown. Can they get it? Murphy's shot is good.
He'll do some damage if they give him that shot. Don't give him a clean look. Get out there on him.
The Bulls have gone 4 of 9 in the third quarter. Pass to Caruso. Brown with it. Outside White. Driving in. Outside Jones. The three is up. The shot misses.
He had more than enough room to hit that. Just couldn't make it happen.
To the middle. Here's Snell. And he slams it in one-handed.
A burst of athleticism. Gets Snell to the rim. And he throws it down.
A minute 31 left in the third quarter. Thompson outside. Outside White. Ooh, poked away. And out of bounds. New Orleans will have it. Taking a look now at the 2K leaderboard. Here are the squads that have been everywhere on defense and piling up the steals since the All-Star break. The Pelicans, number one.
As the season goes on, their defenders have only gotten more confidence, eagerly attacking the ball handlers and being as disruptive as possible.
Now here's Hernan Gomez. Looking at his numbers, currently he's averaging around 9 points a game. Hernan Gomez sets a screen. Shot on the wing. Thompson pulls it in. Chicago leading. There's 47 seconds left in the third. Back to White. Out of bounds. It'll be Pelicans ball. New Orleans has gone 1 for 2 from outside the arc in this third quarter. Pass to Hayes. Graham against White. Graham misses.
Good job hitting the glass. They're +8 in rebounding.
Brown finds White. Pass to Caruso. To end the drought. Misses off the right iron. And so it's the Chicago Bulls with a 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. Their defensive efforts have paid off, effectively shutting down the opposing offense. And don't go far. We'll be right back. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, just shredding the defense with that feed. Zero chance to stop that.
No, it's quick decision making. See a guy open, you can't hesitate. That's an outstanding play.
Fourth quarter action is upon us. Thanks as always for joining us. Chicago has gone 3 of 4 from distance in this game. They've got Brandon Ingram. Jonas Valanciunas out there with Jackson Hayes. Then there's C.J. McCollum, and it's Jones in at the three slot. That's the Pelicans 5. LaVine gets the bucket.
Agile play by LaVine. I mean, finding his way around the contact to a shot.
And here's McCollum trying to make up ground here.
And with plenty of time left, you want to play with urgency, but not desperation.
Pass to Ingram. Hayes with a screen on White. Ingram with the ball. He's picked up by LaVine. Now Jones. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Ingram.
Involving as a playmaker, I mean, Ingram looking very unselfish with the crisp pass to the open teammate.
Chicago shooting around 44%. Not bad. Here's DeSumo. Vucevic, a screen on McCollum. To the paint. By Vucevic.
It sends it home with some passion.
I think he's rubbing it in a little bit here, hanging up there like that. Just an awesome display of athleticism on our AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Ingram, the pass to McCollum. Valanciunas sets a screen. Puts it up from 12. And they'll get another chance. Ingram finds McCollum. Second chance effort. Not enough on that one as it misses.
He has shot them in the foot with his inability to make shots tonight.
Outside LaVine. From 13, Pelicans cleared away. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth here. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
McCollum, the pass to Ingram. Valanciunas with a screen on White. From 7, and Ingram with the finish.
Well, a focal point of this offense, Ingram takes pride in helping lead the charge on offense.
Outside LaVine. Let's go with a 3. The shot, no good. And it's New Orleans taking it the other way. McCollum outside. Pass to Hayes. Here's Valanciunas. And it's New Orleans with another.
He's a go-to guy for them because he's that consistent. Time and time again, he delivers.
The Bulls have gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. 2 for 4 now. Hayes against DeRozan. And here is Vucevic. Jones with the block. Vucevic, a screen on Ingram. Here's White. Here's Vucevic. And Vucevic slams it in.
Well, Vucevic has finished a couple times in the top 10 of offensive boards, in part because of his feel for the game.
McCollum outside. Valanciunas down low, covered by Vucevic. Offensive rebound. Valanciunas, good.
Straight up effort gets him those points. That's what it's all about on the offensive glass.
LaVine with a screen on Hayes. Here's DeRozan going inside.
I love how he takes good angles on drives to the rim. DeRozan has a nice fluidity to his game.
The Pelicans have gone 4 of 7 from the field in the fourth quarter. McCollum, the pass to Hayes. Ingram with the ball. Pass to McCollum. That one's good on the sweet setup by Ingram.
Oh, great flow to that possession. Two players totally in sync with each other.
Now here's LaVine. Into the lane. Vucevic with it. Great look there, but off target.
You got to move past that one. I mean, they'd want him to take that again.
Well, you're exactly right. I mean, that's the kind of shot you're trying to work for at the offensive end.
Green's checked in for Chicago. Ingram with the ball. Pass to Valanciunas. McCollum outside. 6 on the shot clock. Valanciunas sets a screen. It's McCollum with a drive. And Valanciunas gets it to go on the assist by McCollum. And now just a 5-point Chicago lead. Here's Dosunmu. McCollum defends. Vucevic, a screen on Hayes. Here's DeRozan. Lays it up and banks it in. And the Bulls lead by 7.
Maybe he's playing better during winning time. Silent in the first half, but since then, he has taken over.
The Pelicans have gone 6 for 9 here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Hayes. Now McCollum. With the drive. DeRozan with the rebound. DeRozan's got his 4th rebound in this one.
Yeah, just hasn't been able to find his rhythm offensively, and that's having a ripple effect.
The fader, and it's good. Credit LaVine with the assist. Levine's got three assists now in this one. And New Orleans shooting 60% here in the fourth quarter. Terrific efficiency. Up top, McCollum. Green covering. Now here's McCollum. He's closely guarded. That shot off the mark. Chicago has gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. Here's Levine for three. And that bucket makes him 6 for 10 in the contest.
You see the work Levine has put in his three-point shot. Now a legit threat from deep.
McCollum outside. Valanciunas down low. Working on Vucevic. For Chicago, they've gone 7 for 11 so far in the fourth. Pass to Green. Levine against Ingram. Here's Vucevic. That one doesn't drop. Nice D from Valanciunas. McCollum outside. Jones with the ball. Valanciunas with a screen on DeRozan. Will it go? The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Oh, this is the grit and grind Valanciunas gives you. I mean, someone that isn't going to give into the defense.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Bulls.
I love how they've attacked the basket in this game. They've taken a very aggressive approach.
They've also worked very hard to get the ball inside and have been able to get and hit a lot of high percentage shots in this game.
The free throw drops for Valanciunas.
Whether he's starting or coming off the bench, Valanciunas is a nice piece to have. He's a big man who's a nightly double-double threat.
Now here's Levine. Pass to DeRozan. Here's Dosunmu. 54 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
You love a big man like Vucevic. Puts in the effort to keep improving. For example, look at what he's done with his perimeter shooting.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good, and that'll push the lead to double digits. And so Vucevic nails both of them. The Pelicans have gone 7 of 14 here in the fourth from the floor. Levine against Ingram. Book it again. 7 for 12 and going at the defense.
Yeah, I like Ingram's shot selection. He's good at reading defenses and understanding when to shoot aside.
40 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Levine finds DeRozan. There's the drive over Jones. And DeRozan gets it to go on the assist by Levine.
Yeah, they blocked out the noise, blocked out the distractions, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
Showing remarkable poise and focus throughout the game, a sustained effort across the board.
Here's Dosunmu. Pass to Vucevic. Over Ingram. Outside for Green. Here's Dosunmu. On the wing, Levine. So no problem for Chicago as they get the win. Exceptional effort on the road. They were ready and they were focused.
Focused indeed. I mean, it takes a strong mental approach to block out the distractions. These guys stepped up 100%.
And now we have Ali LaForce standing with the player of the game. Ali, take it away.
All right, thank you so much. Vooch, it's got to feel great to just get a win. How important was this one?
It was very important for us. We had our, quite a bit of a rough stretch lately, a lot of losing, and it's not easy to deal with it, you know, but tonight we came out, we got it done, and that's all that matters. You know, sometimes you need a game like this to kind of get going. It was a big win for us. We needed to add one more to the winning column, so big for us. I think helps with our confidence, so that was good for everybody.
It's great to know if you keep your head down, it'll pay off. Thanks so much, Vooch.
All right, Allie, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Chris Webber, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, I'm Brian Anderson. Thank you for tuning in to watch the NBA on 2K Sports. Last but not least, here is your New Balance player of the game, Nikola Vucevic.